Okay, okay. James said y'all can stop a man in a game when he's 8 years old. Tell me about that.
Yeah, unlimited games. We used to bring, I used to go to all my games. So Shane, but like, I say Shane. Shane said, let's put him in. We let him play the last couple of minutes and let him just play. He did okay. He didn't try to do too much, but you know, he passed the ball, not trying to team, but lock his little ass up. Yeah. But people don't forget that he was 13 years old. He played at Rucker. He played at Rucker, unlimited, my own team, my coach.
Wow.
And they've been waiting for him to come down there and back. I was down with Bringham. So I couldn't bring him because he was playing AU ball.
Right.
With New Heights. I finally brought him to two games, right? So now I brought him. It's packed down at Rucker Park. He played against the legend, Chuck Bryan. He played against Chuck and him.
Yeah, I need to my Chuck Bryan. Yeah. Same race.
He played overseas. Right. Well, that's what Chuck played overseas.
Yes.
They beat my son. We got it on video. They beat my son.
Right.
By the end of the game, they double-teamed my son to get the win because they had to put pressure. He had to pass the ball. But my son had 21 points that game.
Wow.
And then the next game, a couple days later, he played at Gaucho Gym Unlimited, and it was against a team. I got it on my highlights. He had 18 points. So he played, and then EJ, then we came down there to watch a game. And EJ shouted him out, like, yo, this kid only 13 years old, and he, no, matter of fact, he was 14 years old, and EJ said, like, yo, he probably was the youngest kid played out here, and the father and son who did it at too young age, and he handled his weight. And people understand, my son plays better. I'm not saying it's because I'm on this. He plays better when he plays with older guys because he got no pressure. You're not going to double team him. That's when he hit the jump shot. He drives, and that and he's good playing with older guys and better players.
We're gonna do one more segment. I'm gonna come back because about the end. All right? I'm coming right back with you.
All right. All right.
Yeah, we back. We're gonna come back. This last segment, my man Malloy Nesmith. Great interview so far, man. Let's talk to my guy.
Keith Stroud's right there, Riverside. A church right there. What's up, bro?
He's Stroud. Riverside Church. Yo, let me tell you something, man. People been hitting me up in my DM about Keith Stroud.
Look at the ref, my man, the ref. What's up, baby?
When everybody,
Easy Money, what up?
For sure. What up, Chris? Everybody's talking like, yo, we need to get Keith Stroud up on here, man. So I sent him those messages, man. Kind of blew him up.
Baby, Shane, the drill machine. Yeah, no doubt.
You know what I'm saying?
Parkside, what up? I see y'all. I see all my people tuning. Let's get this show. Give these people a lot. Shout out. Kenny, I see you. Kenny, you back.
What up?
Oh, my God. It's a shout out.
Go ahead, man.
Kenny right there.
Now I'm coming in the room.
It's my man, the ref, right there. E, that's E right there.
What up, E?
Yo, Reef. What's up, Reef? I see you, boy. See you in there, boy.
Yeah, man. A lot of people leaving in the comments. One of the reasons why your son is not scared and been put in those pressure situations because you were preparing him for those things since he was 8 years old.
Yeah. You know, what I did was I told my son, I said, check this out. I said, you know who your daddy is. They're going to come at you because some people like me, Rob Phelps, some people like me, some people don't like me. And if they don't like me, it's because I'm still around doing what I do on the basketball court.
Right.
You know, I still got this young look. I'm still playing at a high level as I get older. So, you know what I mean? Or maybe the girlfriend talking about me because I still look like I got something. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's a lot of reasons. So I told my son, when you go out here, just play your game. They're going to come at you. So I told him how to do all the dirty tricks, how to play like this. And I told him, be humble. One thing I told him, I said, yo, be humble. I said, you don't have to worry about nothing, man. I said, be be humble because the dad is humble on the court. You know what I mean? But don't worry about what people say and not like that. They're gonna talk this and that. I said you're gonna earn your own name and earn your own thing. You know what I mean? And he's a very humble kid, but he don't take no shit. He'll fight, whatever. He ain't no punk. You know, he got heart.
And he a lefty.
My son got heart.
And he a lefty too.
He's a lefty. Ooh. Yeah, my son's a lefty,
ooh,
man.
Ooh.
He worked hard, man. He worked so hard. He's like a gym rat, you know what I mean? So I really give him props, man, because he owed his own weight, man. You know what I'm saying? But you know, all kids hard heads when their dad tell them some stuff about what to do and what not to do.
Right. But
at the end of the day, he listened to me, and I let him go learn how to play from different people, too. So, like Kareem Reed and all these other guys, I let him watch everybody. I'm not a hater. I said, yo, learn from everybody. That's how you're going to get good. That's what your dad did. You learn from everybody. But at the end of the day, I get the last word to tell him what's good and what's bad. Because he know I'm not going to tell him nothing bad. I'm always going to tell him positive shit. He know I'm going to keep it real with him, what to do and what not to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know? Salute to Jalen, man. I watched the views of his game during
Hold on, Cruise Control. Hold on. I got to get my man Cruise Control. What's up, boy? I gotta get my man a shout out right there.
No doubt, no doubt. DJ Connect said, you remember you working him out at 75 Park. Ron Phelps said, yo, Glenn, his son is legit. I saw him. So, you know, that's definitely from
another. That's one right there. You see what I'm saying, yo? That's my son right there.
What up,
what's up, Jalen?
Yeah, one of the things I like about him, I like his confidence. You can tell he got serious game, and you know he's definitely a product of you. What high school did he go to?
He go to high school? No, he's in college.
I know. What high school did he go to?
He went 2 years at Cardinal Hayes. He played a sophomore year when they took everything in sophomore year, and then I moved him and the moms down to Florida. And he went to Stuyvesant High School, played last year there, and now he had Eastern Florida State right now.
Okay, all right.
But he about to make a power move within a few days. You know, man, I'm not going to make the announcement, but the announcement they will see the announcement soon. I don't want to blow it up.
Okay, all right.
Hold on. I just want to say I want to give him props, my son, because he just did good. He did great on his last finals test, man. We got a couple of A's, a couple of B's, man. Yo,
that's no problem right there, man.
He got A's and B's, but yo, I told him to bet me $500, right? I said, if you get all A's and B's, I'm going to give you $500. He didn't want to take the bet. Said, you know what I mean? So I would have bet on a $500 right now. I'm glad he didn't take that bet. But I'm probably going to stick that. Probably going to stick that like $250. I'm going to give him $250.
Right. That's dope, man. To see how, you know, you kind of stumble in some areas in the classroom, you make sure that he didn't, you know. And now he didn't. He super excelled in the classroom, getting A's and B's, man. So salute to you, bro. Salute to you, Jalen. You know what I'm saying? For staying focused, man. And look, whatever the world gives you, get your oysters right now. You got your father, your mom. You got people that's guiding you. And just listen, do the right thing, man.
Yes, man. It's blessed, man. You know what I mean? I'm just happy that, you know, people's on here. I got a lot of good people's on here with us, you know what I mean? And they never hate. They just show love, you know what I mean? You know, oh, here go the moms right now. Go to mom. Thomas Girl D.
How you doing, Thomas Girl D? All right.
Happy Mother's Day, Dana. I love you like good food.
Salute. This is our Mother's Day special. Give you guys a treat. My dude Future. Future, I have a question, man. I know later on I'm interviewing Khalil Brantley, right? And when I spoke to Dad and told him I was interviewing you early on, he was very excited. I had big praise to say about you. I was glad to share the day with you, man. So have you ever seen that young man play?
I think I seen him play one time a year ago, but the kid is good, I heard.
Yeah.
How tall is he?
He's like 5'9", man. He's like 5'9", and, you know, his father be at the games. I can imagine you at the games. And
right. The
kid, he's not a big talker. He does what he needs to do. He stays focused, and he's a straight killer, man. So.
What year he's in high school?
He's going to be a senior this year.
In high school, right?
Yeah, I watched him at first when he played for Tiny at Nazareth.